Hi fellow beauty finders, this is Matthias Allen and I'm here with another one of my Monday makeup chats. Today on the couch I have my good friend Kelly and we're going to be talking about contouring tips and tricks. Kelly, why don't you tell everyone a little bit about yourself?
Yeah, hi everyone, my name's Kelly. I'm a Hollywood makeup artist and I am from Seattle. I've been doing makeup for almost a decade in television, opera, commercials, high fashion beauty, and personal one-on-one education.
And I've got her here on my couch. All right, Kelly, so tell my followers and my subscribers what is the first thing that just jumps out at you as the must-have contour product.
There are so many things that are great for contouring, and I use heaps of different things depending on the client and the feel.
Right? I mean, we always do. We have to change our kit around depending on the client, depending on the skin tone, dry skin, oily skin, okay.
But I think my favorite one currently is the RCMA Highlight and Contour Palette because you have a really deep tone, you have a medium tone, which works for me, and it would work for Queen Latifah at the same time.
Okay.
And then we have different highlight colors because, let's be honest, highlighting and contouring is like yin and yang.
Yes.
You can't have one without the other. So this palette is super easy to travel with if it's for yourself or in your makeup kit. It's a cream-based product that goes from a cream sort of to a powder, but it's a really silicone.
So it's like a semi-matte finish,
exactly.
As opposed to like a lip gloss or a really creamy blush, you know, it'll dry down to a semi-matte finish. So what I really love about this is that there's a very light yellow highlight, and there's also a very light pink highlight, which is great because we have different complexion tones. So if you're a professional makeup artist looking for a great product, this is it, because there's yellow and pink. I love that. And I love that this brown over here is more of a taupe. There's not a lot of orange in it.
Mm-hmm.
Which brings me to one of my must-have things for you contour queens out there. I really like this new Color Science Mojave bronzer.
Ooh.
It is a taupey bronzer. There's not a lot of orange in it.
Key thing for contouring.
One of my pet peeves is seeing girls use bronzers to contour. And you can't use a bronzer to contour because 9 times out of 10, not all, because look, here's the 1 out of 10.
Right.
No, but most bronzers are very orange, very warm, and you don't want to take a very bright orange bronzer like into your contour.
Because let's talk science real quick, or at least technique.
Okay.
Contouring is a shadow. So we're adding shadow to the face. And if you look at any shadow in your room, in your house, it's going to be a gray cool tone. That's
right.
Just what a shadow is. So when you use an orange on your face, it's beautiful for that sun-kissed look, but not when you're creating shadow. So you want something kind of like this little guy,
mm-hmm.
who's a cooler, grayish
yes.
tone.
If you're using creams, that's a great one. And if you want to do a powder, this is my recommendation. So what's next up on yours? On your side.
Something, contour kit as well. This is a powder compared to our cream. Makeup Forever. This is the number 2, and you can see how much I use it.
She loves it.
The reason I love this too is because if you're in a pinch and you have to run out the door, you have your contour, your highlight, your eyeshadow, and your eyeshadow highlight.
Wow.
And it makes a beautiful, natural highlight. You can throw a liner or mascara on there, and
it's super neutral.
Very neutral.
You know, not too warm. So I love Makeup Forever. It's one of my favorite brands. And I can't recall how many colors those come in. Do you know?
There are 4. So there's
4.
A 1, 2, 3, and 4. I believe number 2 is the most popular. At least I know that I use that on almost all of my skin tones.
You know, I used to work for Makeup Forever back in the 90s.
So did
and
I.
You did?
Mm-hmm.
And their contour kit used to come like this big. It was like a palette, yeah. Like this. And the circles were humongous. There was 2. And I think number 2, the one, this one right here, was like the basic color, which is probably why it's the most popular.
I think it is.
Because it works mostly for everyone,
yep.
Right? Now, Kelly showed you her RCMA cream to powder mm-hmm. formula. I also have a really lovely cream to powder formula that I love from a brand called Senna.
Oh.
Now, some of you have seen one of my videos where I actually spoke for Senna Cosmetics at the IMATS trade show in Los Angeles. So I did seminars with Senna and I got to work with this product firsthand for hours, and I really do love it. If you're a professional makeup artist and you know that you're gonna go through your contour kit maybe faster than that little RCMA one, then get this one because it's huge. And it comes with all these great colors. You can also use this for foundation for darker skin tones, and it's a very matte finish. This is like an oil-free cream matte finish. So
it wears really smoothly and comfortably on almost all skin types. I'm really dry and I love this product.
Yes, perfect. Okay, what's next up on your side?
Okay, this kind of breaks tradition.
Yeah, because that doesn't look like a contour, Kelly.
Guys, this is an eyeshadow. It can be done. Or at least it's not much of an eyeshadow left because I've used it all the time. It's Yamal by NARS.
Yamal.
So, Jamal.
Yamal. What did you call me?
Junot, I say.
Junot.
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 Anyway. So it's an eyeshadow. So this is kind of breaking tradition. You don't have to use a product that's called a contour color or a highlight to get a highlight and a contour. I think with makeup, there really aren't as many rules as we're often told that there are.
Right.
And it's a neutral, cool taupe.
Yeah, I can see that. It's not like a warm chestnut. It's not like a warm sienna brown. It's definitely very cool, very taupey, and it looks really neutral. Now tell me, do you recommend, as I would, not to use a shimmery eyeshadow as a contour, right? That is the one rule. That is the one rule, I mean. Right?
Hallelujah. All right, so we talked about technique again. Shadows with a cooler tone. We want that to kind of sink back to create that nice hollow of an eye or a cheek. Mm-hmm. And with shimmer, it's gonna catch light, it's gonna jump forward, which is exactly what we don't want.
Yeah, no, we don't want that.
So something, a matte, every now and then if you're going with a very ethereal, kind of a glossy,
you might
get away with something that has a bit of a soft sheen.
Right, if you're doing a photo shoot where, you know, the skin is supposed to be really glowy or really frosty, you don't want to take like a super matte contour
exactly.
Line right in the middle, because if it gets photographed from the side, you're going to see shimmer, 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 matte, shimmer, shimmer, shimmer. Yeah, so you're right. There are some instances where you can use a little shimmer in your contour.
Exactly, but be well aware if you're doing a glowy, glossy skin look, a little bit of shimmer is going to, say a little bit of iridescence is going to be okay.
Oh, yes, good
but
word.
Stay away from flecks of glitter or gold.
Yeah, no. Now, do you guys know Poise Cosmetics? Poise Cosmetics is a new brand on the market. It's one of my like new favorites, and they make a really great contour kit for a professional makeup artist that just came out this year. It's called the Mineral Pressed Powder Kit, but it actually works like a contour kit. So there are pressed powders that you can use on set to mattify your clients or your models or your actors, but it also works really great as a contour and highlight kit. And it's very, very mattifying, but it never looks talky or dry on the skin. So that's from Poise Cosmetics. So that's a great contour kit with like 8 colors. So
really
check
versatile.
Them out.
So like I said before, contour and highlight is like yin and yang.
Yeah.
You need to have one with the other or else it's gonna look half-assed.
Yeah.
Can I say that?
Yes, of course. Say whatever you want.
So we talked a little bit about highlighting with my RCMA palette that has a pink tone and a yellow tone.
Mm-hmm.
And you can use whatever you want. It's makeup. You don't really have rules. But if you have more of a golden complexion, using something yellow is going to be beautiful. Likewise, if you're pink, using something with a little bit of a pink, kind of a rosy tone will look great.
Right.
However, Makeup Forever has a star powder called number 940 that's this beautiful combination of pinkish, goldish. It's like a warm opal.
Yes, it's one of my favorites. Oh my gosh, can we swatch it on
yes,
your hand?
Absolutely.
I don't know if we'll be able to see it very well on camera. If you guys don't know what star powders are, they are similar to MAC pigments. I'm sure a lot of you girls out there know what a MAC pigment is. It's that broken up loose eyeshadow with shimmer. But the Makeup Forever ones, I gotta tell you, they feel like flour.
Mm-hmm.
The MAC pigments do not feel like flour. These are very, very, very smooth, very silky, very soft, and the 940 is one of my favorites.
Perfect.
So it's like, basically it looks white, right? But if you get up close, it has a slight pink and a slight golden yellow undertone as well. It gives you the best of both worlds. Can you see it on my finger?
It's so beautiful. So basically, it works for all skin tones. We use it as an eyeshadow. We'll mix it in with our foundation. We use it as a highlight. We'll bathe in it if we can.
And another great pro makeup artist tip for those is that if you're packing your kit very lightly and small, like say you don't want to bring like a big suitcase with all these different things, I think using the Makeup Forever Star Powder in 940
mm-hmm.
would be a great product to bring as opposed to shimmer loose powders. You know, a lot of companies
yes.
come out with these shimmer loose powders that are like in these jugs and, you know, they make the shine and this and that. You can take this and mix it in with your loose powder on a little card or a little table or on your palette and then mix the two together with a blush brush and you get a shimmer loose powder.
Exactly.
That's great.
It's
great,
so
great
versatile
tip.
And it is going to be this beautiful natural highlight with a sort of an ethereal glow that you can wear every day.
All right, you guys, I hope you enjoyed this Monday makeup chat talking about some of our favorite contouring products. I hope you guys will subscribe to my channel because I do 3 weekly series on Mondays, Tuesdays, and Fridays. So please subscribe. There's a link right down here below for you to do so. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at Matthias for makeup, and follow my good friend Kelly. Kelly, tell everyone what your Instagram and Twitter handles are.
My Instagram is Kelly Thorpe Makeup, and my Twitter is K Thorpe Makeup. So follow me, I'll follow you back.
Thank you, Kelly, for being here. I so appreciate it. You guys stay tuned because Kelly's going to be back with me in just a few short weeks for another Monday makeup chat. All right, you guys, thanks for watching. Please subscribe. Leave me a comment if you have any questions. I'd love to answer them for you here on my YouTube channel. Also, please leave me a thumbs up if you like this video. And there are 2 more videos for you guys to check out. So stay with me, explore Find the Beauty with Matthias Allen, and I'll see you soon.